So what is moving observer method and what is the use of it, we will see. So by using this method, see, if you want to find flow on a road, what you will do? Finding flow. How can you find flow? Srinivas, flow means what? Number of vehicles?
Number of vehicles per hour or time.
Yeah, number of vehicles per unit time, right?
Yes, sir.
Vehicles per unit time at a given section. That is flow actually. Okay. So you can find this flow just by counting the vehicles for a given time. Suppose if you count the number of vehicles traveling on a road in one hour, and let it be n vehicles or q vehicles per hour, then flow is q vehicles per hour. Okay, that is the flow. So just directly by counting, by standing on the roadside, okay, and counting on a stream, one direction, vehicles, okay, so you can get the flow. But moving observer method is an indirect method. Moving observer method is an indirect method. Indirect method to find traffic parameters like flow, speed, average speed, okay, journey time, density, etc. Okay, so these parameters can be determined by using this moving observer method. Okay, so what is the theory and all, we will see. So how to derive this, I mean formulas and all, we will see. Let us assume suppose this is the road section we have chosen. So instead of standing at a single point, we choose a road section from some one point to another point, that means some d distance. Okay, let us assume this road section is d distance. D distance. And assume vehicles are passing uniformly like this. Just assume like this, okay? Vehicles are moving. It is a one-way traffic. I assume it is a one-way. Okay. Moving in this direction. Vehicles are moving in this direction with the Q. We don't know Q. Okay. Density, let us assume K. Speed, let us assume V speed. Okay. Average speed is V. Assume like that. Okay. Then in moving observer method, what is mean by moving observer means the observer, the person who is counting the vehicles will be sitting in a car. And car will be moving along the stream and against the stream. So here, moving observer method basically. In moving observer method, the person will be sitting in a test vehicle. Test vehicle and vehicle will be moving along the stream, and counting the number of vehicles, overtaken. Overtaken by test vehicle and number of vehicles overtake the test vehicle. Okay. See, moving observer will be moving in the traffic direction only, like this, with some velocity, and he will be counting. Okay, so suppose test vehicle overtakes the some other vehicle, then he will count that also. Otherwise, suppose traffic stream vehicle overtakes this test vehicle, that also will count. Okay, similarly, test vehicle moves against the stream. That means in opposite direction. Okay, against the stream, and he counts the number of vehicles met him. Okay, so as traffic is moving in left to right direction, and the moving observer will be, first he moves in along the stream, then against the stream. That means after some time, then again he moves in other direction. That means I will draw that also. The traffic will be moving in this direction, but test vehicle will be moving in opposite direction like this. Okay, by the time when he moves in opposite direction, obviously he met vehicles. Okay, some vehicles will be coming opposite to him, so he counts that also. Okay, number of vehicles met him. So based on this data, okay, of course he records the time taken for along stream flow and against stream flow. That means suppose this section is A, this section is B. To travel from A to B, how much time he takes, the test vehicle. Similarly, to travel from B to A, okay, how much time he takes, that also he will count, he will record. Okay, so finally what he is recording, Kirti, ఏం రికార్డ్ చేస్తున్నాడమ్మా?
టైం టేకెన్.
వాట్ ఇస్ రికార్డింగ్ డేటా? First one, so when he moves along the stream, what he can record? Number of vehicles overtaken by test vehicle. B, number of vehicles overtake the test vehicle. And what else? C, time taken to travel the d distance, d the stretch, d distance. So similarly, when he moves against the stream, what he will count? A, number of vehicles met him, that means against him. Okay, number of vehicles coming towards, I mean opposite to him, so he will count. And of course, time taken to travel again the distance. So this is the data available with us. Okay, with this data we need to find all the parameters. Okay, so based on the theory, we need to develop some formulas. Okay, so let us assume finally, let T1 be the, okay, I will give numbers here itself. Let us assume this is T1, this is T2.
Sir, voice break out, sir.
Yeah, ippudu vastundi kada. Let us assume time taken to travel d distance, this one, when test vehicle moves along the stream, let us assume it is T1. When vehicle moves against the stream, let us assume that is T2. Number of vehicles overtaken, let us assume N1 equal to number of vehicles overtaken by the test vehicle. Minus number of vehicles overtake the test vehicle. Let us assume that is N1. N2 equal to number of vehicles. Okay, that is when test vehicles moves along the flow. N2 equal to number of vehicles encountered by test vehicle when he moves against the stream. Okay, so these are the parameters N1, N2, T1, time taken by test vehicle, to travel the distance when he moves along the stream, and T2 equal to time taken by test vehicle to travel the distance when he moves against the stream. Okay, so finally these are the four parameters to find all those things. Okay, so N1, N2, T1, T2. So N1 means, suppose the test vehicle number of vehicles overtaken by the test vehicle. Okay, so test vehicle is overtaking. Okay, suppose he overtakes some 20 vehicles and some fast moving. So some vehicles may be moving faster than the test vehicle. Obviously, the faster going vehicles will overtake the test vehicle. That, see, the number of vehicles overtaken by the test vehicle minus number of vehicles overtake the test vehicle, that is the net overtakings, okay? Net overtakings by test vehicle is N1. So it is actually net overtakings by test vehicle, okay? Suppose he overtakes 20 and other vehicles overtaken the test vehicle is suppose 5, then effective is 20 minus 5, 15. 15 is the net overtakings by test vehicle. Clear kada N1 ante andarki? మనం వెళ్ళేటప్పుడు ట్రాఫిక్ లో వెళ్తూ ఉంటాము, మనం ఓవర్టేక్ చేస్తుంటాము, మనల్ని ఓవర్టేక్ చేస్తుంటారు అన్నమాట. టెస్ట్ వెహికల్ ఎన్ని వెహికల్స్ ని ఓవర్టేక్ చేసింది మైనస్ టెస్ట్ వెహికల్ ని ఎంతమంది ఓవర్టేక్ చేశారు. ఓకే, టెస్ట్ వెహికల్ ఎన్ని వెహికల్స్ ని ఓవర్టేక్ చేసింది మైనస్ టెస్ట్ వెహికల్ ని ఎంతమంది ఎన్ని వెహికల్స్ ఓవర్టేక్ చేశాయి అనేది N1 అన్నమాట. N2 అంటే ఆపోజిట్ డైరెక్షన్ వెళ్తున్నాడు స్ట్రీమ్ కి, ఆ ఫ్లో కి ఆపోజిట్ డైరెక్షన్ రిటర్న్ జర్నీ వెళ్తున్నాడు అనమాట మళ్ళీ వాడు మూవింగ్ అబ్జర్వర్. ఓకే, అప్పుడు ఎన్ని ఎదురొచ్చాయి వీడికి, ఎన్ని వెహికల్స్ ఆపోజిట్ గా ఎదురొచ్చాయి అనేది N2 అనమాట. సో T1 ఈస్ టైం టేకన్ బై ద ట్రావెల్, టైం టేకన్ బై ద టెస్ట్ వెహికల్ టు ట్రావెల్ డి డిస్టెన్స్. ఆ స్ట్రెచ్ ఏదో పెట్టుకుంటాడు, 5 కిలోమీటర్స్, 10 కిలోమీటర్స్. సపోజ్ అమీర్పేట్ టు కుకటపల్లి, అమీర్పేట్ టు కుకటపల్లి పెట్టుకున్నాడు అనమాట. అమీర్పేట్ నుండి కుకటపల్లికి వెళ్తున్నాడు లాంగ్ ద స్ట్రీమ్. సో అంటే లెఫ్ట్ సైడ్ వెళ్తున్నాడు అనమాట మనకు, టూ లేన్ ఏమంటుందని, డ్యూయల్ లైన్స్ ఉంటాయి కదా, పోవడానికి లేను రావడానికి లేను. సో టెస్ట్ వెహికల్ ఏం చేయాలి ఇప్పుడు, సపోజ్ అమీర్పేట్ టు కుకటపల్లి ఆ ఫ్లో మెజర్ చేయాలనుకుంటున్నాం మనము, ఆ ఫ్లోలో కలిసిపోతాడు అనమాట మూవింగ్ అబ్జర్వర్. ఫ్లోలో కలిసిపోయేసి మనకు అమీర్పేట్ నుండి కుకటపల్లి ట్రావెల్ చేస్తూ అవంతా కౌంట్ చేసుకుంటాడు అనమాట. తర్వాత ఆపోజిట్ లో వచ్చినప్పుడు ఏ పక్క రావాలా, లెఫ్ట్ లెండ్ రావాలా రైట్ లెండ్ రావాలా?
రైట్
రైట్ లో రావాలి. అంటే ఆ స్ట్రీమ్ ఏదైతే ఉందో ఆ స్ట్రీమ్ లోనే కలిసిపోయి ఆపోజిట్ లో వస్తుండాలన్నమాట. బట్ రూల్స్ ట్రాఫిక్ రూల్స్ కి అగేనిస్ట్ అది, ఎందుకంటే ఆపోజిట్ లో రాకూడదు కదా. కానీ వీడు టెస్ట్ వెహికల్ కాబట్టి మనం పారామీటర్స్ మెజర్ చేసుకోవడం కాబట్టి మనకు పర్మిషన్స్ ఉంటాయి. సో ఆ స్ట్రీమ్ లో మీరు ఆపోజిట్ లో వస్తుంటారనమాట తప్పించుకుంటూ. ఓకే, డేంజర్ అనమాట యాక్చువల్ గా, అంటే యాక్సిడెంట్ జరిగే ఛాన్స్ ఉంటుంది. అయినా మీరు సైడ్ లో వస్తూ ఉండాలన్నమాట. అదర్వైజ్ సర్వీస్ రోడ్ ఉంటే సర్వీస్ రోడ్ లో వెళ్తూ కౌంట్ చేసుకోవచ్చు, ఇబ్బంది లేదు. సర్వీస్ రోడ్ ఉంటే కనుక సర్వీస్ రోడ్ లో వెళ్తూ కౌంట్ చేసుకోవచ్చు, లేకపోతే అదే రోడ్ లో ట్రావెల్ చేస్తూ వెళ్ళొచ్చు అనమాట. వెళ్తూ ఎదురుగా ఎన్ని వెహికల్స్ వస్తాయి కౌంట్ చేసుకోవాలన్నమాట. అది N2, టైం కూడా కౌంట్ చేసుకుంటాం T2. ఓకే, నౌ థియరీ ఇస్ లైక్ దిస్. సో యాక్చువల్లీ రిలేటివ్ ఫ్లో QR1 ఈక్వల్ టు క్యూ మైనస్ KV1. దట్ మీన్స్ సపోజ్ లెట్ ఫ్లో ఈజ్ క్యూ. వినపడుతుంది ఇప్పుడు శ్రీనివాస్?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Let flow is Q. See, what is KV1 means? Here V1 is actually, Q is basically flow in kilometer per hour of the stream. K is density. Density in vehicles per kilometer. See, V1 is speed of test vehicle while going along the stream. That means, see, Suppose this is the road. Vehicles are moving like this, okay? Suppose this is the d distance. Okay. Obviously, if you stay at a single point and count, then you will get how many vehicles? Q vehicles you will get, okay? If you stay at A and count for 1 hour, then you can count Q vehicles, right? Q vehicles you can count. But you are moving from A to B. You are moving from A to B. What happens? If you move from A to B and counting, you will miss some vehicles, right? You will miss some vehicles. Actually, in that time, actually in 1 hour, what happens? You are going from A to B. Okay. You are at B. After 1 hour, you are at B. Obviously, you cannot count all the vehicles. That's why how many vehicles miss means, so K into V vehicles will miss. Okay. What is K into V? Density into velocity is what? Flow, right? So missing vehicles is here. Missing vehicles K into V1. Okay. So that's why it is Q minus KV1. So that is relative flow. So you can count only QR1. Okay. If you stand at a point A and if you count, you will get a Q count. Okay. You are moving along the stream means obviously you will get lesser than that. Assume like this. Suppose traffic stream is traffic vehicles are moving with a V velocity. You are also moving with a V velocity. Then what happens? Road vehicles V velocity some 80 km pace. Any vehicles 80 km pace to equal spacing. So meer kuda 80 km pace tone elthunaru along the road. Meer any vehicles overtake cheyagalutaru? Mimmalni any vehicles overtake chestayi? No overtake. Meer any vehicles ni overtake cheyaleru endukante meer elthunna speed kuda adhe speed kabatti. Okay na? Meer antakante ekku speed tho elthane kada overtake chestaru ante na? మీరు అంతకంటే ఎక్కువ స్పీడ్ తెలితే ఓవర్టేక్ చేస్తారనమాట. సో ఆ విధంగా మీకు అంతకంటే తక్కువ స్పీడ్ తెలితే మిమ్మల్ని ఓవర్టేక్ చేయబడతారు, మీరు ఓవర్టేక్ చేయబడతారు అనమాట. సో రిలేటివ్ ఫ్లో ఈక్వల్ టు క్యూ మైనస్ కేవీ వన్. సిమిలర్లీ వేర్ క్యూఆర్ వన్ ఇస్ రిలేటివ్ ఫ్లో విత్ రెస్పెక్ట్ టు టెస్ట్ వెహికల్ ఓకే ఆర్ మూవింగ్ అబ్జర్వర్. With respect to moving observer, when moving observer moves along the stream. Similarly, QR2 equal to Q plus KV2, where QR2 is relative flow with respect to moving observer. When moving observer moves against the stream, okay, against the stream. Similarly here V2 is nothing but speed of test vehicles when he moves against the stream. Okay, okay sir, so these are QR1 QR2. Okay,
kilometer per hour lo ichar sir.
Ema
flow in kilometer per hour an rasaru vehicle per hour lo.
Sorry, that is vehicles per hour. Flow vehicles per hour. Okay. Sarpindama. So QR1, QR2. Suppose then net, you see, let's assume time taken is T1 and T2. Already we have discussed, okay, T1, T2. Just multiply this one. QR1, T1. QR1, T1 equal to QT1 minus K into V1, T1. Similarly, QR2, T2 equal to QT2 minus KV2, T2. So from this we can write QR1, T1.
Plus.
Yes.
Sir, plus QT2, yeah, plus QV.
Plus. Okay. Yeah. QR1, T1. So flow into time is what? Relative flow into time is what? Number of vehicles, right? So from this, N1 equal to QT1 minus K. Here V1, T1. Velocity into time is what?
Distance
traveled. Yeah. D. So the D is fixed actually. Okay. Similarly, when moving in opposite direction, N2, see QR2, T2 is N2 equal to QT2 plus KD. So these are the two simple equations we can solve it. Okay. So this is A, this is B. So you can, sometimes you can use this AB equations, or sometimes you can use 1-2 equations. Okay. So finally, we got this one, these relations. QR1 equal to Q minus KV1, QR2 equal to Q plus KV2, or sometimes N1 equal to QT minus KD, N2 equal to QT2 plus KD. Either these equations or these equations can be used. Okay. So in these equations, knowing this N1, knowing N1, N2, K, N1, N2, T1, T2, T1, T2, and D, we can find Q and K. Okay, Q and K can be determined. So how to find Q and K? So no need to remember these derived formulas. You can derive whenever you want. Okay, Q and K, how to find Q and K, we'll see. So adding, what happens? N1 plus N2 equal to Q into T1 plus T2, right? KD gets cancelled. Obviously, Q equal to N1 plus N2 by T1 plus T2, right? That is Q. Antena? Correct? Antena? Okay.
Yes, sir.
Then K. How to find K means?
Correct, sir.
Yeah. To find K, what to do? N1 minus N2 or N2 minus N1 equal to Q into T2 minus T1 plus 2KD. Yeah? 2KD, adding that, subtracting, okay, from 2 to 1. So then 2KD equal to, can you find like this? Otherwise, okay, one second. We'll eliminate Q, that is N1 T2 equal to QT1 T2 minus KD T2. N2 T1 equal to QT1 T2 minus KD T1. Okay, now subtraction. N2 T1 plus, right here. Okay. n2 t1 minus n1 t2 equal to, that gets cancelled, kd into t1 plus t2. So from this, k equal to n2 t1 minus n1 t2 by d into t1 plus t2. So this is the k. So knowing this n1, n2, t1, t2 and d, you can find k also, q also. Okay, what else can be determined using this? This is k, now this q, this is k. How to find average journey time? So average velocity of the flow. How to find average velocity of the flow? Average velocity of flow. Suppose V bar equal to Q by K, right? Q by K is the average velocity of flow, which is equal to, what is Q? N1 plus N2 by T1 plus T2. N1 plus N2 by T1 plus T2 divided by, what is K? N2 T1 minus N1 T2 by D into T1 plus T2. N2 T1 minus N1 T2 by D into T1 plus T2. Okay, here T1 plus T2 gets cancelled. That equal to N1 plus N2 by D comes here into D by N2 T1 minus N1 T2. This is the average velocity of flow, V bar. V bar can be worked out like this. Then average flow, average journey time. Average journey time for d distance equal to t bar equal to, see, time is average velocity into, I mean distance, right? Sorry, distance by velocity. Distance by velocity is time, right? Distance is d by average velocity, this one. Okay, that's it. That equal to d by v bar, that is n2 t1 minus n1 t2 by n1 plus n2. Okay, like this you can find all those things. Okay, average journey time for d distance, n2 t1 minus n1 t2 by n1 plus n2, because q, k all we got, so v bar is there, so d by v bar, that is t bar. See the problem number 383 problem in our material. While traveling along and against the traffic stream, a moving observer measured the relative flows as 50 vehicles per hour and 200 vehicles per hour respectively. Okay, the average speeds of moving observer while traveling along and against the stream are 20 and 30 kilometer per hour respectively. The density of the traffic stream is, okay, while traveling along and against the stream, moving observer measured the relative flow. So QR1 equal to how much? 50 vehicles per hour. QR2 equal to 200 vehicles per hour. So QR1 means along the stream count. Okay, when vehicle moving observer is moving along the stream, moving observer is along the stream, and moving observer is along the stream. This is relative flow. Moving observer is against the stream. Then it is 200. Average speeds of the moving observer while traveling along and against. Okay, that is v1 equal to 20 km/h. Moving observer speed when he moves along the stream. V2 30 km/h. Moving observer speed when he moves against the stream. So these are the things given. Okay, he is asking find the density k equal to question mark. So no need to remember anything except these basic things. QR1 equal to Q minus KV1. QR2 equal to Q plus KV2. Substitute here. 50 equal to Q minus K into 20. Another is QR2 200 equal to Q plus K into 30. See, two equations are there, two unknowns are there. We need one unknown, that is K. Just subtract 1 from 2. 2 minus 1. 150 equal to QQ gets cancelled. So 30K minus of minus plus 20K. So 50K. So from this, K equal to 3 vehicles per kilometer, like that. Okay, so very simple. So only the thing we need to understand these two equations properly, QR1 QR2 relations. Okay, this is 2016 gate problem on moving observer. Okay, next. Clear andariki?
Yes sir.
Okay, doubtless. Okay, next. See, 384th problem. An observer traveling at a constant speed of 70 km/h with the traffic stream over a 5 km stretch is passed by 17 vehicles more than he passes. Okay. He moves slowly actually. That means here our formula we need to correct, N1 N2 relation actually here. Number of vehicles here, you correct this N1 actually. N1 is number of vehicles overtake the pest vehicle. Number of vehicles overtake the test vehicle minus number of vehicles overtaken by test vehicle. Actually, slow moving observer will be moving very slowly. So net overtakings, not by test vehicle, net overtaking the test vehicle. Net overtakings. Overtake is the test vehicle. Okay, correct that. N1, then only net flow will be there. Otherwise flow you will get in opposite direction, right? Negative value you will get. So when observer travels against the stream at the same speed, the number of vehicles he meets is 303. The flow of the traffic stream is, so you know, given here is speed v1 equal to v2 equal to 70 km/h, right? An observer traveling at a constant speed of 70 km/h, and he again he told that at the same speed, when the observer travels against the stream at the same speed, so v1 equal to v2 equal to 70 km/h. Distance given is 5 km stretch. Okay, 17 vehicles. Okay, he 5 stretch is passed by 17 vehicles more than what he passes. Okay, so net overtakings is n1 equal to 17. When the observer travels against the stream at the same speed, number of vehicles he meets is 303. N2 equal to 303. So formula is like this. Flow is asking q equal to question mark. Okay, formula n1 equal to qt1. What is that? Minus kt, right? Minus kt. N2 equal to qt2 plus kd. Of course, t1 equal to t2. See, from this v1 v2 you can find t1 t2. So t1 is what? Time d by v1, right? t2 equal to d by v2. Distance is fixed 5, v1 is fixed 70, 5 by 70. T2 also same, distance is fixed, v2 also same 70, so 5 by 70, t1 t2. So knowing all these things, you can work out this q easily. So just we'll substitute here first. N1 is what? 17 equal to q into t1, 5 by 70 minus kd. N2 303 equal to q into 5 by 70 plus kd. Add 303 plus 17, 320 equal to q into 10 by 70. So from this q equal to 320 into 70 by 10. 320 into 7, how much? 0, 7, 2 is 14, 1, 22. Okay, 40 vehicles per hour. So, make up the mind clear. N1 is chaser, N2 is chaser direct. N1 and net overtakings and yanta mandi test vehicle overtake chaser and net flow. ఎవరు బట్టలు చూస్తున్నారు? ఓకే, క్లియరా?
Yes sir.
ఓకే కీర్తి, క్లియర్
అమ్మా?
మీకు N1 అనేది ఎంతమంది ఈ టెస్ట్ వెహికల్ ని ఓవర్టేక్ చేశారు, ఎన్ని వెహికల్స్ ఓవర్టేక్ చేశాయి అనేది N1 అన్నమాట. N2 అంటే ఆపోజిట్ లో వచ్చినప్పుడు ఎంతమంది. మనకి T1 T2 డైరెక్ట్ గా ఇవ్వలేదు, బట్ వెలాసిటీస్ ఉన్నాయి, డిస్టెన్స్ ఉంది కదా. వెలాసిటీస్ డిస్టెన్స్ ఉంటే మీకు T1 T2 వచ్చేస్తాయి అన్నమాట. ఓకే, నెక్స్ట్. ఓకే, ఐ విల్ గివ్ వన్ మోర్ ప్రాబ్లం. సపోజ్ ఇన్ ద సేమ్ ప్రాబ్లం N1 ఈక్వల్ టు 17, N2 equal to 303, distance equal to 5 km. Okay, T1 equal to, what is that, 5 by 70, T2 equal to also 5 by 70. Find density also, density K. Okay, so again write equation 17 equal to q into 5 by 70 minus k into d 5. 303 equal to q into 5 by 70 plus k into 5. Okay, then subtract 2 1 2. So 2 2 minus 1, what happens? 303 minus 17. That is 286, huh?
Yes, sir.
Equal to, this gets cancelled. So, 10K. K equal to 286 by 10. That equal to 28.6 vehicles per kilometer. That is the K value. Okay. Similarly, suppose say N1 equal to, what is that N1? 17. N2 equal to suppose 303. T1 equal to, T2 equal to same. What is that? 5 by 70 hours. D equal to 5 kilometers. Find average speed of flow. Average speed of flow in KMH. Okay. So average speed means V bar Q by what? Q by K. So in previous this one we got Q 2240 K 28.6, which is equal to
78.3
kilometers per hour. That is the average speed of flow of the stream. Okay. Also find average journey time.
Average time.
For 5 kilometer stretch. Okay. Okay, average journey time for 5 kilometer stretch. So, time equal to distance by velocity, average speed. So, distance 5 kilometers by 78.3 equal to 5 by 0.0638 hours, which is equal to into 60 means minutes. 3.83 minutes. This is the average journey time, T bar, okay? So like this, anything can be determined. Well, average velocity, average time, density, average density, I mean density of the flow, average density of the flow, average flow, all these things can be determined, okay? Next. See the 385th problem. 385th. A student riding a bicycle on a 5 kilometer one way street takes 40 minutes to reach home. Okay. So cycle 5 kilometer velladaniki 40 minutes padutundanta. Pattindanta. Okay. The student stopped for 15 minutes during this ride. The 40 minutes lo mottham travel cheyaledanta. 15 minutes rest isukunnadu anamata somewhere ekkado kuchoni. Ante 25 minutes travel chesadu anamata. 40 minutes pattindi. 15 minutes కూర్చున్నాడనమాట ఒక చోట అలసట వచ్చి 60 vehicles overtook the student. 60 vehicles overtook the student. వాడు వెళ్ళేటప్పుడు 60 vehicles పాస్ అయినాయి అన్నమాట. Assume the number of vehicles overtaken by the student is 0. అతను ఎవరిని ఓవర్టేక్ చేయలేకపోయాడు సైకిల్ కాబట్టి. ఓకే. During the ride and 45 vehicles while the student stopped. స్టూడెంట్ ఆగి ఉన్నాడు కదా 15 మినిట్స్ ఆ టైంలో 45 వెహికల్స్ వెళ్ళాయన్నమాట. ద స్పీడ్ ఆఫ్ వెహికల్ స్ట్రీమ్ ఆన్ దట్ రోడ్ ఈజ్ స్పీడ్ ఆఫ్ అంటే విబార్ అడిగాడు అనమాట. ఓకే. సో మనకి ఏంటి, మనకు తెలిసిన ఈక్వేషన్స్ ఏంటి, n1 ఈక్వల్ టు q t1 మైనస్ వాట్ ఇస్ దట్ kd నా ఇంతేనా. N2 equal to QT2 plus కేడి ఒక్క నిమిషం. See, in these equations, when student takes rest means, obviously, relative flow mean, relative flow, this term won't be there because velocity is zero. I mean, actually, this equation comes from QR1 equal to Q minus KV, right? KV1. If this is zero, then obviously, QR1 equal to Q. So in our case, he is taking rest means QR1, Q both are same. This term won't be there in our case. Manam moving observer lo em chesamu agane along the stream against the stream em chesadu move avutunnadu kada. So ikkada along the stream case lo manaki ikkada vaadu rest isthunnadu kabatti velocity zero kada. Velocity zero means QR1 equal to Q kada. So accordingly n1 equal to only qt1 anamata. Okay, so in first equation n1, while he is taking rest, he counts 45 vehicles. How many vehicles? During the 45 vehicles while the student stopped. So while student has stopped means n1 equal to 45 equal to q into how much time he taken rest? 15 minutes, right? 15 minutes means 1/4 hour. Okay, see here, n1 equal to 45, t1 equal to 15 minutes, that equal to 1/4 hour. Okay, that is the equation 1. Then another equation is, while he moving, he counted 60 vehicles. Okay, that means 60 equal to 'll do one thing here. This one we'll keep like that, and we'll see QR2 equal to Q plus. When it going against, actually Q plus, what is that, K V2. So your V2, EVT is zero, so this is zero. Okay, that means our first case, stop case, stop case moving along the stream case, along the stream. So first case is moving along the stream, second case is stop case. Stop case means velocity zero, that's why qt2 only. Okay, clear kada? So when moving along the stream, what is the count? 60 vehicles overtake the student, right? 60, n1 equal to 60 vehicles overtake the student, and t1 equal to 15 minutes. Adena correct na? Sorry, 15 kada, 25 minutes. Journey time enta? 25 minutes kada? 25 minutes, okay. Journey time 25 minutes. 40 మినిట్స్ లో 15 మినిట్స్ రెస్ట్ తీసుకున్నాడు, 25 మినిట్స్ ట్రావెల్ చేశాడు అన్నమాట. సో అప్పుడు కౌంట్ చేసింది, ఓవర్టేక్ చేస్తున్న వెహికల్ కౌంట్ చేసింది 60. సో n1 అనేది 60. సో d వచ్చి మనకు తెలుసు 5 కిలోమీటర్స్. ఓకే, తర్వాత n2 వచ్చేసి స్టాప్ అయి ఉన్నప్పుడు ఎన్ని వెహికల్స్ కౌంట్ చేశాడు అంటే 45 వెహికల్స్ అన్నమాట. ఎంతసేపు కౌంట్ చేశాడు? 15 మినిట్స్ కౌంట్ చేశాడు అన్నమాట. సేమ్ డి వచ్చి సేమ్ అనమాట. ఓకే, డి అవసరం లేదు ఇక్కడ. సో ఇఫ్ యూ సబ్స్టిట్యూట్ హియర్, 60 ఈక్వల్ టు క్యూ ఇంటూ టీ వన్, 25/60, because in hours minus k we don't know d 5 kilometers okay then n2 45 equal to q into t2 15 minutes that means 15 by 60 that's all okay is stop okay relative motion is same as flow that's why so using these equations we can find what is asking the speed of the vehicle stream okay vehicle stream speed okay first find k so from second equation this is equation 1 this is equation 2 so from second equation q equal to 45 into 60 by 15 15 threes 180 vehicles per hour q then substituting in q place so 60 equal to 180 into 25 by 60 minus k into 5 so k equal to 63 so 5k equal to 75 plus 60 so from this k equal to 75 plus 60 135 right
minus 60 75 minus 60
75 minus 60 yeah 75 minus 60 k equal to 15 by 5 3 vehicles per kilometer k after knowing the k value speed equal to q by k q is 180 k is 3 60 kilometer per hour okay like this सो बैसकल रेस्ट मन सैकंड केस वी टू जीरो फस्ट के अलांग स्ट्रीम पोतना अभी क्यूटी वन माइनस केडी अलाने अन्मा ईक्वल टू ओके